Good morning, my name is Ruth Beck and I'm the SDSU Agronomy Field Specialist based out of Pierre, and I'm here today with Dwayne Beck, who is the manager of the Dakota Lakes Research Farm for SDSU near Pierre. And today we're going to talk about growing field peas in South Dakota, or field pea production in South Dakota. So first of all, if you aren't familiar with field peas, they're a legume. They're an excellent source of protein, and they basically are an important component of human diets around the world. Field peas are adaptable in many areas of the state, so that makes them appealing to a lot of people. They fix their own nitrogen. They're a legume, so they fix their own nitrogen, which reduces farmers' input bill and also reduces our dependence on energy, since there's a lot of energy used in fertilizer nitrogen production. Also, field peas add a lot of diversity to our crop systems, which is a good thing, because it tends to allow us to get away from some of those weeds that we see in some of the more traditional crops, weeds, diseases, insects. And it allows us to use different herbicides, which can help us to deal with herbicide-resistant issues that we're starting to see more and more in weeds. Peas have multiple marketing options. They're a good source of livestock feed. They're an excellent human food. And so there's a lot of markets that they can be sold into. In South Dakota, we plant two types of field peas. We have yellow field peas and green field peas. The yellow cotyledon type of pea is typically more popular in the state of South Dakota. They're a little easier to grow, they produce a little bit better, and they actually are very appealing to livestock producers. We also do see some green field peas grown. These tend to be a little bit more prone to disease, so they yield a little bit less typically, and they're prime market is human food market, and what we can see is the green peas can bleach, so that will bring them down. They won't be allowed into the human market, but they still can be sold into the livestock market, so there is that salvage market there if they bleach.
Peas are large seeded. That means they need a lot of moisture in order to germinate. We like to plant them deep enough that they can get enough water to germinate, so it usually means 1.5 to 2.5 inches deep. So they can get enough moisture. We want 350,000 pure live seeds, so you're going to want to get a good germ and test before you start, and then also get a seed count so you know what's going on there. If they're not thick enough, they can't knit together and help each other stand up with the modern types we have. You should have about 8 plants per square foot. You need to handle peas with care, and this is a huge issue with peas. So as you go, if you got the germ test and germ is good, and then you go to take them to your field, you can easily damage them. So don't handle them when it's cold. Use belts and not augers and all those kind of things. Cracked seed coats can reduce the germination, also get you going with disease. So again, use belts, do not handle when cold. Warm the seed if possible. So use your aeration fans to warm it on a warm day if you're getting ready to seed, or one of the things guys do is get them out and into the drill field in the fall, and then move that into a building and warm it up in the spring. There's a lot of ways to make your air seeder and your seeders more gentle, pad and towers and whatever, so check with your manufacturer to make sure you've got all that stuff in there. And then, as I said, get a germ test and include cold germ, and also do a disease assay, so that helps you out. Take a sample from your air seeder once you've got it in the tank, and then run the seeder at normal operating speed and air pressure, and take a sample from the openers, and then take those into the house and do a germ test on them and see if you're damaging the seed at all. If seeding peas in cold soils, or if you're not sure the seed condition or what quality seed you had, you might want to consider using a seed treatment. If you're using granular inoculant, that helps. You can use a seed treatment without interfering with that. If you're only using a seed-placed inoculant, then maybe you want to be a little cautious on virgin soils. If you're going into ground that's had a disease concern in the past, then you for sure need to use a seed treatment.
Okay, so again, field peas are a legume plant. So that gives them, they have that ability to obtain much of their nitrogen requirement from the atmosphere by forming a symbiotic relationship with the rhizobium bacteria in the soil. But in order to maximize that relationship, they need to be inoculated. So for first-time pea producers especially, it's recommended that they use 2 different types of inoculant at a full rate. make sure they get that seed inoculated properly. Field peas have their own type of inoculant, so it's not a soybean inoculant. You need to make sure when you purchase that inoculum that you check the date, that it's not expired, and once that seed is treated, that seed should be planted as quickly as possible. If that treated seed sits in the truck for a couple of weeks before you have a chance to seed it, then you probably that can assume that that inoculant is dead and you need to re-inoculate those peas. A lot of the producers in South Dakota are very happy with granular inoculant products. They seem to show better performance under tough conditions. So be sure you get proper inoculant done. You cannot afford to miss in that area. So if you want to check for nodules on peas, it's really important when you dig up the pea plant that you use a shovel and you get the whole root. Because what happens if you pull up the pea plant, they don't have a real strong stem like wheat or something, and the nodules will break right off that root. And you will think you're not getting nodulation. So really important to get the whole root base of the plant there. And then carefully break that soil off, and then you find the nodules are still there when you break that soil off. Okay. So this shows really good nodulation on the roots of the pea plant. You can see all these little bumps, and if you look closely, the bumps have a slight pink tinge to them. If we broke them open, they would look pink or red on the inside, and that just tells us that they're working. So this is where the nodule, the rhizobia live inside these nodules, and they fix the atmospheric nitrogen. It's a symbiotic relationship between the rhizobia and the pea plant. They fix the atmospheric nitrogen and make that available to the pea plant. So we don't use fertilizer nitrogen on the peas.
One of the most controversial issues in pea production probably is whether or not they need to be rolled. If you're seeding conventionally and you're using a hoe drill, then I suspect that you probably want to roll. And if you're going to roll, you'll want to do that after the seed has germinated and the plant has actually emerged from the soil. The problem with rolling is it can lead to diseases in terms of bacterial blight and stuff, because you're going to do damage to the plant and you're also going to put it in contact with the soil. The other problem we see with rolling in no-till situations is you break the residue free, and then if you get a rain or a big wind, it all blows into the shelter belt to the edge. So our preference is to if you're using disc seeders and no-till, to leave it alone and not roll it. And some farmers say they can't get a combiner to combine it then. I guess I'd look for a different combiner.
Okay, so just to talk a little bit about the growing stages of peas. Peas germinate and their cotyledons remain underground, which is a hypogeal type of germination, and this protects the growing point of that plant for a little bit longer in the spring. And then when they start to grow up, the first two nodes each have scale leaves at those nodes, which are just basically they don't develop. And then it's the third node that has the first true leaf, and that first true leaf consists of a tendril and two stipules, which are leaf-like in nature. And what happens with the field pea is if that main stem gets some damage from frost or hail, then it can develop, that pea plant can develop branches and leaves from those two scale leaves at the base of that plant, and that can help that plant compensate from something that might have damaged the main stem. If you are interested in more information, it's available at igrow.org, or you can look at www.southdakotapulsegrower.com. You can contact either Dwayne or myself, Ruth Beck. Our information is also on igrow.org.
This project was supported by the Specialty Crop Block Grant Program, the U.S. Department of Agriculture, also by SDSU and the South Dakota Pulse Growers Incorporated.